Good morning, students. Today I am going to start my fourth lecture for the subject chemistry for class 10th. The name of chapter is acid bases and salt, in which in the previous class I was taught about the base. Now I am going to discuss about the type of base. Our base are classified into two types: strong base and weak base. Strong base, those bases which dissociate into ions completely, is said to be a strong base. Those bases which dissociate into ions completely in water solution are said to be a strong base. Those bases which dissociate into ions completely in water solution solution called a strong base. Strong base. Example: sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, etc. Those bases which dissociate into ion completely in water solution called a strong base. Now weak bases, those bases which do not dissociate completely into ions in water solution are said to be weak base. Those bases which do not dissociate into ions completely are called solution in water. Those bases which do not dissociate into ions completely, completely are called weak base. Weak base. Example: calcium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide, etc. So we can say that those bases which do not dissociate into ions completely in water solution, and do not dissociate into water completely in water solution, called weak base. Those bases which do not dissociate into ions completely in water solution called weak base. It means our bases are as classified similar to acid, as we have classified the acid in a strong acid. Acid is classified into a strong acid and weak acid. Similarly, our base is also classified into a strong base and weak bases. A strong base means there is a complete dissociation of base. There is a complete dissociation is said to be a strong base. And incomplete dissociation, or we can say that partial dissociation, is called weak bases. Complete dissociation of base is said to be a strong base. And incomplete dissociation, or we can say that partial dissociation is said to be weak base. Now we are coming on the properties of bases, in which we first we study about the physical properties of base. The first property is this: bases are, they are bitter in taste. Second property, they are soapy to touch. Third property, they turn red litmus paper into blue. Fourth property, they conduct electricity in aqueous solution. Now we are coming on the chemical property of acid. Chemical properties of acid. Sorry, chemical property of base. Now we are going to discuss about the chemical property of base, in which the first property is that action of base on acid. Base reacts with acid to give salt and water. This reaction is also known as neutralization reaction. Base reacts with acid to give salt and water is said to be, is also called neutralization reaction. It means when base reacts with acid to give salt and water. NaOH, HCl, NaCl, plus H2O. Second, the second property is that action of base on some metal. Action of base on some metal. Some metal. Like some metal. Action of base on some metal. Base like sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide, they are also called alkali because they are soluble in water. So here our action of base on some metal, in which zinc reacts with sodium hydroxide to give sodium zincate Na2ZnO2 plus release hydrogen gas. Zinc also reacts with potassium hydroxide to give potassium zincate plus hydrogen gas. It means zinc metals reacts with sodium hydroxide to give the salt sodium zincate Na2ZnO2 plus hydrogen gas. Zinc metal also reacts with potassium hydroxide to give potassium zincate and release hydrogen gas. It means when zinc metal reacts with sodium hydroxide to give sodium zincate Na2ZnO2 is called sodium zincate and release hydrogen gas. Action of base on non-metallic metallic oxide. Calcium hydroxide reacts with non-metallic oxide, carbon dioxide. Here, action of base, our calcium hydroxide is base. Calcium hydroxide reacts with carbon dioxide gas to give calcium carbonate as a salt and release water. It means the reaction between non-metallic oxide and base is also neutralization reaction, because in this case our salt calcium carbonate is formed. So here our base reacts with carbon dioxide gas. It is carbon dioxide is non-metallic oxide. It means, as we know that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So here is it is acid. It behaves like acid and it is base. And here after finishing the chemical reaction, we get calcium carbonate and water. So here the reaction between calcium hydroxide and carbon dioxide gas to form calcium carbonate and water. Aqueous gas, we are solid. These are the three property. So here we should know one thing is also know about it. So those bases which are soluble in water are said to be alkali. Those bases which are soluble in water are called alkali. It means we can say that all alkali can be base, but all bases cannot be alkali, because all bases are not soluble in water. Once again, I am saying that about the alkali. Alkali word has derived from the Arabic word. Arabic word, Arabic. Arabic means alkali, chariye. So here we can say that those bases which are soluble in water are said to be alkali. So we can say that all alkali can be base, but all bases cannot be alkali, because all bases are not soluble in water. Those bases which are soluble in water are called. Here our the chemical property of bases has been finished. Now I am describing about the alkali. Those bases which are soluble in water are called alkali. Example, NaOH, KOH, NaOH. Now today my class, the fourth lecture is going to finish. Thank you. Dhanyawad.